Rochelle, I'm gonna start it now. Oh wait, we just went live. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. shout at us now.
Welcome to Class 7's graduation ceremony. My name is Karina Rojas. I'm a graduate of Class 7, and I have the pleasure of being your Master of Ceremonies this evening. Tonight is a culmination of 1 year of hard work, classes and internships, infractions, teachable moments, laughs, and tears. This event also has the distinction of being our first ever graduation ceremony. At first, I was worried hosting this event virtually would be challenging, but then I realized a few things. If I forget my script, I can just freeze awkwardly and let you assume my internet's buffering. I can secretly wear sweatpants. If you don't laugh at my jokes, I can just play a laugh track and pretend. On a more serious note, 2020 has been a year of challenges. We faced a global pandemic, rising police brutality, a shaky job market. Specifically with this community, we balanced these hardships with a lot of wins. We were the first year of class to successfully complete remote internship and begin our careers in spite of an economy ravaged by COVID. Several people in this community are already celebrating the start of their jobs post-year. Specific shout outs to Hawaii and Motion Pictures Association, Melanie and Jacinda at AT&T, Jessica at DaVita, Alan at Families and Schools, Jesus at Facebook, Julia at Sony. Personally, this has been a year of juggling multiple priorities. I'm a mother of two with one on the way, a wife and intern at Kaiser Permanente, and now a graduate of Europe Los Angeles. As a woman in this professional space, I've come to realize our ability to truly do it all. I can point out several women in this community that I count as role models. Tammy G, Tammy H, Jennifer, Monique, Bernadette, Rochelle, Jacinda, Julia, Melissa are our mothers navigating their careers with great success. And you inspire us to plant seeds for the future in spite of current challenges. With that being said, I have the pleasure of introducing one of those role models, site director at ULA, Jennifer Gutierrez Caldwell.
Greetings, Karina. You are such a natural. Good evening and buenas tardes, graduates, friends, family, and supporters. Thank you for joining us to celebrate ULA's Class 7 graduates tonight. Again, I am Jennifer Gutierrez Caldwell. I serve this passionate and dedicated site as site director. I would like to take a moment to highlight this past year and express my dear gratitude to all the key players in making today a reality. During my Europe onboarding, Europe was explained to be very much like a runway, and each student a high quality plane full of potential. On August 19th, 2019, each of you began a journey on your individual runways. You were met with many high expectations from your runway crew, i.e. exciting contracts. It didn't take long for you to realize that those high expectations were accompanied with very high support. You dedicated 6 months in our learning and development phase of program where you worked on job readiness skills, countless Monday morning kickoffs, Friday feedbacks, and guest speakers. Thank you to our college partner, West LA College, President Limbaugh, our VPs, the deans, faculty, staff, facilities, and sheriff's department. Our West LA partnership created the opportunity for our students to complete their IT and business coursework during L&D. On January 16th, 2020, you heard for the first time where you would be placed for your 6 month internship phase of program. The energy and excitement that day that filled Aviation Technology Complex with vibrations, it was just truly exciting. As Karina mentioned, you all made history within Europe to successfully complete our organization's first virtual internships due to the pandemic. Thank you to our dynamic corporate partners and direct managers that are committed to our mission of closing the opportunity divide. Thank you for the mentorship and for walking alongside our graduates at internship. We could not do the work that we do without you. I also want to thank our EULA team, true servant leaders and social justice soldiers, who not only serve this team in their functional role, they also serve as coaches. I have never seen a more talented, people-centered, mission-driven team, a team that does not play when it comes to coaching responsibilities. Thank you to the families and supporters of our Class 7 graduates. Every plane needs that support system to encourage and guide them. Now today, July 29th, 2020, Class 7, you did it. We are so proud of you, are so proud of all your hard work and dedication to make it to this day. We have been here on this runway with you and are thrilled and truly honored today to see you fly. Thank you. Buenas tardes a todos, graduados, amigos, familiares y apoyadores. Gracias por acompañarnos para celebrar la clase 7 de Year of Los Angeles. Otra vez, yo soy Jennifer Gutierrez Caldwell y sirvo a este sitio apasionado y dedicado como la directora de Year of Los Angeles. Europe es muy parecido a una pista de aviones, y los estudiantes son ese avión. Esos estudiantes han sacrificado y dedicado su tiempo, trabajado todo un año con la meta de empezar no solo un trabajo de saldo mínimo, pero toda una carrera. Empezaron su trayectoria en este camino el 19 de agosto del 2019. Dedicaron 6 meses en nuestra fase de aprendizaje y desarrollo del programa, donde aprendieron las habilidades necesarias para ser exitosos en ese trabajo. Continuaron los próximos 6 meses con su internado en una corporación para ganar la experiencia necesaria para comenzar su carrera. Les queremos dar gracias a toda persona que ayudó a cada estudiante a llegar a este día, a la Universidad de West LA, al equipo de Year Up Los Ángeles y a nuestros socios corporativos y a los amigos y a cada familiar que le brindó apoyo cuando las cosas estaban difíciles. Nosotros estamos muy orgullosos de todos nuestros estudiantes, de todos sus esfuerzos y de todo su trabajo. Hemos estado con ustedes en esta pista apoyándolos y hoy es un gran honor y un gran orgullo verlos volar. Muchísimas gracias. And unfortunately, our next speaker, Dr. Jim Limbaugh, president of West LA College, had a family emergency tonight and will not be able to join us. Dr. Limbaugh has been a fierce advocate for our students and their success. He is not only a true champion for the college, but overall for the Culver City community. He wanted to make sure that his message was delivered to students. So now it is my great pleasure to introduce Araceli Aguiar, vice president of West Los Angeles College. Thank you so much for being with us.
Good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. It's great. I've attended many of your prior graduations, and I've had the pleasure to work with a great team of deans and faculty that have been supportive for this program and are highly committed to seeing our students succeed, especially Europe students. We really value each and every one of you. We appreciate everything that you do. We want to thank the Europe team, the partners, the sponsors who have created this unique opportunity for students. And West is honored to have you on our campus and continue to support the students. I hope that all of you continue forward. And it is truly wonderful to see the success of the Europe students and the hard work and the commitment and the tenacity to continue forward so that they can be successful, have wonderful employment, support their families, and really change your lives. So again, congratulations, Class 7. I'm very happy to be here and join you tonight in this graduation. This unique graduation, I must say. Yes, and it's beautiful. What a beautiful a video. I had a lot of fun watching it. And yes, I miss the in-person contact, the getting together and seeing the students hug each other and the family. And so congratulations.
Thank you, Araceli, for your kind words. BRF is also celebrating its 20th year anniversary. So it seems appropriate that our next speaker was the inspiration for this organization and movement. David Heredia is an accomplished artist devoted to creating artwork and animation that celebrates diversity. David's professional background includes 20 years of experience as an animator and graphic designer. And he is the founder of Heroes of Color, an art organization that promotes inclusion and diversity through art and education. Further, David is the little brother to our CEO and founder, Gerald Shertavion. Their mentor-mentee relationship laid the groundwork for the Year Up program as we know it today. Please join me in welcoming our commencement speaker and a member of the Year Up family, David Heredia.
Thank you so much, Karina. I'm not that little anymore, but I'll still take it. congratulations to everybody. This is such a huge milestone. Graduating from Year Up is an incredible accomplishment, but the milestone that I'm referring to is each of you have successfully broken a cycle that many of us get caught up in. I mean, that can include, you know, feelings of hopelessness, feelings of procrastination, feeling like we're not good enough, you know, or whatever other things we do to self-sabotage ourselves. And it would have been so much easier for every one of you to just continue complaining about the situation that you're in and stay in your comfort zones, you know? So why is it that all of you chose to rock the boat? You know, and I thought about that, and to me, it seems obvious because you all want to change. You know, all of you have gone through a magnificent, magnificent transformation from being, you know, from taking part in Year Up and the training and the mentors and the, you know, the workshops. I only got a small taste of what you guys go through in the actual program, you know, so, I mean, I commend you for that. And you have to remind yourself that all of you have changed, and you are not the same person you were prior to Year Up. Your ambition has changed. Your tenacity has increased. You want more, you know. Think of it like a kind of like a computer program. You know how the computer gets an upgrade? Well, now everybody's upgraded. You know, you're a new version of yourself. You know, and perhaps the best upgrade is the confidence that you all now have to meet any obstacles that come your way. And, you know, this graduation, don't get me wrong, the universe is not done with you yet. You still got some doozies coming your way. You've got some obstacles that are gonna, you know, step in front of you. But take comfort in the fact that you'll be able to get through it because of the family members that you have on your side, the mentors that you've had working with you throughout Year Up, and your incredible new network of friends and associates, you know what I mean? So you guys are, you're a big family now, and lean on each other for advice, for just conversation. You know, one of the obstacles that I want to sort of bring to your attention, I heard many of you got jobs already, and I think that that's fantastic. Congratulations. Some of you maybe have not been placed, but I know for me, it was a little bit of culture shock when I first got into corporate America, and everybody was white. And I was like, oh, this was unexpected. And I think for me, I had a hard time dealing with that, you know? And I just wanna remind all of you guys, the best piece of advice that I'm gonna give you is get comfortable being uncomfortable, because it's the only way that you're gonna grow through whatever it is that you're going through. You know, if you're coasting, then you're not, it's not challenging you enough. You know what I'm saying? Let me share a really quick story about how an uncomfortable situation ended up being the biggest transformation in my career as an artist. So in 2016, Gerald invited me to this, it was like a tech summit. It was called Patel. And he was just like, come with me. I don't feel like going by myself. I showed up and it was just crawling with rich white CEOs. Everybody was a rich white CEO in the tech industry. So, I mean, I'm good. I mean, I can mingle with the best of them. But there was this workshop. It was a poetry workshop. And I wanted to get involved in it, but they stopped me at the door and they were like, you can't get in because you're not you're not signed in as a guest. So I was like, man, I really wanted to get into this workshop. So when she looked away, I snuck in and just sat down and just, you know, I acted like I belonged there. And the guy who was conducting the class was like, all right, I want everybody to write a kind of like a spoken word talking about some product or something that you're really proud of. And I'm not gonna lie, I was a little bit intimidated because he started like sort of pointing out all of the CEOs that were in the room. And I'm like, wow, this is crazy, you know? So I was like, I'll go first, you know, I'll read my poem. I got up and I just looked at it as an opportunity to promote my brand and the stuff that I was working on. And, you know, when you get into your jobs, whether you're interning or I don't know if you guys have already been placed, but for the ones of you that have been placed, you always want to keep thinking about what's next. You know, what's the next level? Don't stay comfortable where you are. Learn what you can and move up. You know, keep doing that because that's one of the best things that can help the trajectory of your career. So while we're in this poetry class, I finish my poem and this woman comes up to me and she says to me, you know, I really loved what you said and, you know, your product sounds really interesting. Do you have a children's book? I didn't have a children's book. I had no plans to work on a children's book, but I lied and I was like, yeah, as a matter of fact, I am working on a children's book and I'm almost finished with it, you know? And she's like, okay, great, because I'm gonna introduce you to the VP at Scholastic. And I was like, oh man. Now listen, I'm not encouraging you guys to lie. That's not the point of this story. But what I'm saying is, you know, I knew what I was capable of. All of you should already know what your abilities are and what you're capable of. So if an opportunity comes, you absolutely need to seize it. You have to be ready for it. And sometimes these opportunities come up just like that. And you have to be ready to jump in any direction. So when this woman made this offer, I was like, absolutely, I'm ready to go, you know. And it was interesting to me because I was able to accomplish something that most first time authors, because I had never been authored before, published a book, was able to accomplish, which is number one, I got a publishing deal with one of the largest publishers in the world and without an agent, which is unheard of. Usually you have an agent who represents you. And I pitched something that didn't even exist, which was amazing. So I say that story to share with you that Europe has given you the tools to defy those exact same odds that I was able to defy. You know, all of the skill sets that you guys have learned, that you guys have put into practice, all of that is gonna be gold for you. Trust me when I tell you that. I saw some pictures of you guys doing like these little one-on-one sessions. You know, another great piece of advice is wherever you're placed, I heard some people are at Facebook, some are at Hulu, think about where you want to be in that company 5-10 years from now. And if you're trying to get to a senior level editor or whatever the case may be, reach out to the editor right now and say, hey, look, I'd love to take you to lunch, you know, and just learn more about you and find out how you got where you got. You know, I'm so interested in learning as much as I can. Nobody's going to turn down an opportunity to talk about themselves, especially if it's something where you're highlighting their achievements, you know, it makes them feel really good. And then afterwards, they're gonna be like, wow, you know, that was really cool of so-and-so to take me out to lunch. You know, they may be busy, but you find a time to, you know, to meet with them on their schedule. But these are the things that you wanna start doing. You wanna start networking within the company that you're already placed in. It's always amazing to me how one decision that you make in life will alter it forever. And your decision to show up, to year up, it's gonna change the trajectory of everything from this point on. Not just your life, but the lives of your families as well. and friends, because you might inspire them to want to follow in your footsteps. So I want to thank all of you, number one, for inviting me here to share within, you know, this momentous occasion. But also I want to thank you for reminding me that the only goals in life that we cannot accomplish are the goals that we lose sight of. And none of you has lost sight of what your goals were when you started year up. So you did it. Congratulations. It was an unorthodox way of knocking it out, but you did it. You know, so all of you are going to do great things in life. I don't doubt it. You're going to do great things in life. I can feel it. And I just want to thank you again for inspiring me and inspiring my children, because they know about year up, you know, and they know about the struggle that the work that's involved in, you know, in being in this program. So again, I want to congratulate all of you. I want to extend the big thanks to all of the staff and all of the faculty members who have just been so, you know, helpful in being passionate about this path, you know, because it's not just a job. You know what I'm saying? You can't have a job like this and not really feel it. That impact that you're having on every single one of these students is a lifelong thing. You know, so thank you for pouring your blood, sweat, and tears into making sure that every one of these students leaves with a new level of confidence. So thank you again, and congratulations, everybody.
Thank you, David, for joining us today. I want to introduce a colleague, a friend, an inspiration of a big brother. We all have our role models, people we look up to. This person has been a role model of mine, and I'm sure to many others. His resilience in the program and reminding himself of his why and the support of his community has propelled him. Without further ado, let me introduce you to our community keynote and SCANS Health Plan newest help desk associate, Jason Tyler Green Jr.
Hello, Class 7 graduates. Before we get into the meat of this message, I would like to congratulate every one of you for this astonishing accomplishment. The road to this destination was not an easy one, as Europe is hard enough without Corona time. But seriously, one transition after another, we rose and exceeded expectations. So please take a second to reflect on the journey and realize the shoes you were able to fill. You all are one of a kind, and I'm grateful to call you my family. With that said, I would like to officially introduce you to Mr. J. Growing up, I was the oldest of five. My mom and dad had two of us together, divorced when I was six, and went on to have a few kids of their own. My dad was in and out of the picture when I was a kid. Not entirely his fault, but he fell for the trap and chose the streets as his escape. My mom took the divorce hard, turned into the bottle as a crutch because that's all she saw growing up. She struggled to hold jobs for long periods of time as the alcoholism would eventually rear its head. We never stayed in any place for long periods of time, bouncing around from family to friends and ultimately shelters. She would try her best, but she was sick and it took a toll on my family. I really didn't know how to handle all this back then. It forced me to grow up quickly as I was exposed to the grim reality this world has to offer at a young age. Growing up with this weight, I didn't know how to process my emotions, mostly because I never felt like I fit into any group. I didn't really look like anyone around me. I wasn't black enough for my black peers. I didn't speak Spanish, so I didn't really fit in with my Latinx peers either. I lacked an identity. Eventually, I would open up to a few close friends, but they can never truly understand what I was going through. The culmination of my circumstances pushed me to have an isolated mentality. I didn't want to burden anyone with my problems. Instead, I adopted a mask to hide behind. I was different and lived different, so therefore I had to move different. I like to help those around me, but I never let anyone be my light back then. I did, however, meet someone special in high school that was able to bring out the room me. Flash forward now to my junior year. I was living with my uncle at the time, since I was too old to stay in the shelter with my family. I was called in the office one day, and I'm told my mom got locked up for driving drunk with my brothers in the car. My brothers were taken away to foster care the first time that night. This trend repeated itself throughout the next few years, when my brothers would come home and eventually get taken away again. One time, 3 days before Christmas, I decided to start working amidst all this, as I didn't want my mom to worry about me. With money taking over as my focus, some mistakes I made, and the slow college system, I chose to throw away chasing my education. I wanted to stay close to home, and I needed a faster route to relief. It took me some years to figure out I wasn't really going anywhere. I was lost then with no clear path laid out in front of me. Only after talking to a coworker of mine at the time, where he told me to check out IT programs, that simple conversation opened the door for me. I did my research that night and stumbled on Europe's door. Now, when I said research, I turned to a private investigator too, because it all seemed too good to be true. However, much to all of our surprise, Europe was legit. With that realization, I decided I was tired of feeling helpless and decided to make some real changes in my life, much like all of you did. Now, I would love to tell you that I went through the program with flying colors. I didn't. It was a struggle, but it is still a success story. My journey began with late mornings, missed assignments, and too many close calls. I was struggling to adjust to the new lifestyle, and above all, the commute. I was determined from the start to be the best version of myself, yet I kept slipping up. I continued to tell myself I can get myself out of the hole, only to dig deeper. Now, Europe from the gate told us that they were all about closing the opportunity divide. I paid attention, of course, but only thought they were doing so by helping us start potential career paths. I couldn't see the whole picture at the time. It honestly didn't hit home for me until we met the founder and CEO of Europe, Gerald Chartavian, where he started his introduction to us awkwardly looking each of us in the eye for a moment. He then explained to us that he was looking in the eyes of future leaders and that we would eventually pave the way forward to change in this country. He truly believed in us without knowing us. So that's when I decided to trust the process. I opened up, got off my high horse, and accepted the support fully. And the passion to really give my all began to burn. To quote Dr. Marshawn Hyman, you don't build trust and then be vulnerable. You build trust by being vulnerable first. I took these words to heart as I wrote my recommitment essay to my staff and peers. I was in danger of firing myself. I wrote that essay to share with everyone what I was going through, what I will do to improve, what I need for my community, and my future after Europe. I reflected on everything I shared to you as I put pen to paper. I wanted to use my setbacks to inspire those around me to keep going. And I can now see the mistakes that I have been making since I was a kid. I had no trust, no words. My silence was the residue of my pain. I began to realize that though no one person may be able to relate on every level, there were those who did share my pain. Through that pain, we found strength to overcome and a passion to see others succeed. We began to support one another, pushing, pulling, and extending our hands for help when it was needed. Now we've earned and claimed this milestone as a memento for all the hard work, tears, laughter, and friendship. This, however, is just the beginning. My story is not the only one that deserves to be heard today. You all deserve to be heard. The power for change has always resided in our voices. It's not just about more representation in the corporate world to show white America that we're here. It's to be a model for those who feel helpless, for those who don't know how to choose themselves, for those who are hurting and share our pain. Through Europe, we have become the blueprint to fixing our broken communities. The answer is simple: educate, love, and empower. Now more than ever, can we hear the loud cries from our brothers and sisters ripple across this country. and my life experiences taught me that we're not alone in this fight. We all have the same goal. It's time to trust your purpose, have those hard conversations, and above all, it's time for true justice. Thank you.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. I can go country, grab and buy. I can go bust, eye for eye. I can lose trust, quite wrong. Fizzy pop, where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the trash, man, it's so tough.
All right, yo, put the belly on the body, make a clutch. Tino watch, now she wanna give crutch. Boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod. Man, a real life sugar gal, let my forget what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top. Switching lanes the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus. Maybe this a Moncler sweater, diesel denim. Buy another one, my pockets fat like heather. Neck froze like I don't know no better. Benzo truck, white seats and they leather. Go broke never, on my grind. She make it clap like I'm Busta Rhymes. I got the juice, the sauce and all them things. I blammed her twice a night with all my bling. Big Benz, I drive, I brought that ting. Any girl you want, they want my ting.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown or white. I can go country, grab and buy. I can go bust, eye for eye. I can lose trust, quite wrong. Fizzy pop, where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Climb the trash, man, it's so tough. Flood my eyes, make a whole blush. Back of the tour bus, getting cool up. D-square, got on de-stress, got a hand wash. New racks with the old Nikes in the shoebox. Keep my stripes, no cut.
That video was so much fun to watch. You guys are way too fly. Great job, Class 7. Good evening, everyone. My name is Jasmine Bass, and I serve as the Student Services Manager at Europe Los Angeles. Tonight, I have the pleasure of presenting two community members with well-deserved recognition. The Year Up program is an incredibly rewarding and, as you know, challenging opportunity for our students and interns. For the past year and a half, we have had the pleasure of collaborating with Providence St. John's Mental Health Services for our Year Up students. St. John's has ensured our students are connected with the mental health support they need while completing the program and beyond. David Alvarado has been a key factor and leader in ensuring our students are connected to therapeutic services. During this time, David has remained committed to making sure referrals were done as quickly and smoothly as possible for our students and interns, contributing to their success in this program. We are so grateful for his commitment to our program and support to our students, which is why we are awarding him and the St. John's team with our Community Partner Award. Thank you, David and the St. John's team, for all of your hard work and dedication.
Thank you so much, Jasmine. Congratulations, everybody.
The next award I will present is our Volunteer of the Year Award. Our volunteers are a crucial ingredient to the success of Year Up Los Angeles and our young adults. This graduation, we would like to recognize and celebrate one of our mentors. This individual has had multiple touch points with our young adults, including facilitating seminar lessons, serving as a competition judge, and has volunteered as a mentor to our interns for the past two cycles. They have gone above and beyond to provide high support and a strong learning environment. Recently, she has created a series called Fireside Chats, where she invites her network of seasoned professionals to have conversations with our young adults. She always finds a way to remain involved and always joins us in our efforts towards the mission. It is our honor to recognize Francesca Grader with the Volunteer of the Year Award. Thank you, Francesca, for all you do. And now I'll pass it to my colleague, Rose Francois.
Thank you so much, Jasmine. And congratulations again, David and Francesca. Good evening, everyone. I am so excited. My name is Rose Francois, and I have the pleasure of serving Europe Los Angeles as one of two program managers. I am honored to present three graduates in my learning community with distinguished recognition. The first award I will present this evening is the Academic Empowerment Award. This award identifies a student who has not only persisted, yet has gone above and beyond in maintaining their commitment to their education and internship experience. This award is accompanied by a $500 scholarship for furthering the education. The students all had to submit an essay of application to consider for the committee. And tonight, I would like to present this award to Melissa Bloss. Congratulations. Awesome. The next award is the David Reddick Award for Excellence. Now this award is in memory after two Year Up champions, David Reddick and Chris Mello. The students receiving this award have inspired others to excel and held incredibly high standards for their own actions and behavior. They have truly established a standard of excellence for others to follow. And just as David did, our recipients consistently pursued excellence in their own work and encourage others to do the same. This also is accompanied by a $125 scholarship and goes towards education and career pursuits. Tonight, the David Reddick Award for Excellence from LCR goes to Belen Trujillo. Well deserved, Belen. And last but not least, I will present the Chris Mello Award for Leadership. Throughout his life, Chris Mello was a leader, both professionally and personally. And his passion for athletics, Chris quietly established himself as an exceptional leader. And he led with his actions, with his commitment, with his work ethic, and with his integrity. The recipient of this award has embodied those same qualities and has gone above and beyond for their consistent display of leadership. This also comes with a $125 scholarship and goes towards education or career pursuits. Please help me congratulate tonight's winner, Alan Martinez. Yay! Congratulations, everyone. So proud. All right, and now I will pass it off to Dr. Marshawn Hyman to present his learning community with their awards.
Good evening, everybody. So excited to be here. So excited to present these awards this evening. So the Academic Empowerment Award and a $500 scholarship towards educational pursuits goes to a very deserving student. I would like to congratulate LCM's Zaria Smith. Congratulations, Zaria. I saw your reaction. Yes, so deserving. The students elected to receive the David Reddick Award for Excellence and a $125 scholarship is Christina Quintana. Congratulations, Christina. These reactions are amazing. I appreciate y'all. And lastly, the recipient for the Chris Mello Award for Leadership and a $125 scholarship goes to Jason Green, who also happens to be the keynote speaker for class 7 tonight. Thank you so much for your leadership, Jason, and your dedication. You represent your class well, and we are all so very proud of you. Congratulations to those recipients. So it is now the time that we've all been waiting for. So get ready to hear your name called as I announce our LCM graduates. So first we have Billian Aguilar, intern at Kaiser Permanente. Diego Morales Hernandez, intern at Bank of America. Mario, AKA Maza Beltran, intern at Marsh & McLennan Companies. Mauricio Leon, intern at Cedars-Sinai. Jacinda Castillon, intern at AT&T. Eden Finale, intern at the Jewish Federation. Jonathan Flores, intern at Live Nation. Demi Gamboa, intern at BuzzFeed. Jason Green, intern at Scan Health Plan. John Huntley, intern at Hulu. Maki Ifuku, intern at Sony Pictures. Tyler Jones, intern at Morgner Construction Management Group. Matthew Kim, intern at Cedar Sinai. Amber Lazamba, intern at Kaiser Permanente. Ernesto, aka Dominic Medrano, intern at Universal Music Group. Jose Melendez, intern at Universal Music Group. Jessica Miramontes, intern at DaVita. Luis Montanez, intern at Universal Music Group. Gabriel Morris, intern at SpaceX. Christina Quintana, intern at The Getty. Victor Rodriguez, intern at Martin Luther King Community Hospital. Karina Rojas, intern at Kaiser Permanente. Zaria Smith, intern at Universal Music Group. Samantha Velasquez, intern at Universal Music Group. Rayvon Vickers, intern at Universal Music Group. Ricardo Zaragoza, intern at Snap Inc. Sabino Zarate, intern at Martin Luther King Community Hospital. And last but not least, Elijah Zavala, intern at The Getty. Congratulations, LCM. I'll now pass it off to Rose for the presentation of LCR graduates.
Thank you so much, Marshawn. LCR, get ready. So excited. All right, we'll begin with Marcus Adams, intern at Kaiser Permanente. Matthew Almodovar, intern at DaVita. Michael Angulo, intern at SNAP. Guadalupe Berbera, intern at Sony Pictures. Melissa Bloss, intern at Morgner Construction Management and Year Up. Eden Campbell, intern at The Getty. Matthew Esparza, intern at Sony Pictures. Julia Grant, intern at Sony Pictures. Reina Gutierrez, intern at SNAP.
Hello, everyone. I think we might be experiencing some technical difficulties. Can everyone hear? I think I'm live. Okay, I see some head shaking. So I think it might just be, we might have lost Rose. So
I'm back.
Where she's back. Okay, Rose, fantastic. For a second, I thought I was the only one frozen. So I think we're good to go. Thank you, Rose.
Yes, the devil is a lie. Let's continue. Reina Gutierrez, intern at SNAP. Nathaniel Hale, intern at Universal Music Group. LaRon Harrelson, intern at Facebook. Lily Henson, intern at Universal Music Group. Natalie Hernandez, intern at The Getty. Lily Henson, intern at Universal Music Group. Lynn Nguyen, intern at Hulu. Emily Johnson, intern at Sony Pictures. John Lee, intern at Live Nation. Alan Martinez, intern at Kaiser Permanente. Jermaine McLennan, intern at Universal Music Group. Geraldo Mondorosa, intern at Live Nation. Araceli Morales, intern at Bank of America. Trey Nguyen, intern at Hulu. Onida Mola Okewale, intern at Universal Music Group. And Josiah Pittman, intern at Universal Music Group. Jesus Chantez, intern at Marshall McLennan Companies. Melanie Sanchez, intern at AT&T. Najee Tate, intern at Universal Music Group. Damian Torres, intern at Hulu. Belen Trujillo, intern at Hulu. Anthony Williams, intern at Snap. And Garrett Williams, intern at Amazon. Congratulations, graduates. You did it. And now I'll pass the mic to our MC for the evening, Karina Rojas.
Hello, I want to take this time and share my story. I want to start off and say I am not a victim, I'm a survivor. I've gone through some unimaginable things, but that doesn't make me less, it makes me a warrior. When I was 7 years old, my dad was a drug addict. He would abuse my mom in ways that a person should never. I was maybe too young to understand, but I knew enough that a man shouldn't hit someone the way he would. My mom, my siblings, and I were moved to a shelter where we couldn't go out. Then we were moved to a trailer where we ate the same thing every day because my mom couldn't afford anything else. After all that, my sister and I promised each other that this was the last time we were going to let any man put a hand or suffer the way our own dad did to us. 2 years later, my dad got sober and remains sober to this day. The abuse didn't stop there. When I was 16, I started dating. I started dating the father of my kids, which back then we didn't have kids. I fell in love. My parents didn't approve, of course, and screamed and yelled. I wasn't allowed to see him. I went behind their back. And maybe it was my mistake in falling in love, but to this day, it doesn't feel like a mistake. It feels right. On March 21st, 2016, I still remember the day my dad did something to me I would never forget. He beat me until I was on the floor and he would not stop. I don't remember how I had the strength to get up, but somehow I did. I got up, left, and never looked back. I remember thinking back to the promise I made my sister, which was not letting any man, not even our own dad, put a hand on us. I was not going to stay and show weakness. Alan and I started our life together. We had two kids. He worked two jobs to keep a roof over our heads. We lived in a very small studio. Imagine Alan and I, plus our two kids in one bed. How crazy is that? But that was our home, and I loved it. Alan was the one who first heard about Europe. He thought for sure it was a scam. So did I. Not gonna lie. But the more we investigated, the more Alan wanted to be a part of it. If he wanted to make this work, he knew we had to make some sacrifices. He was going to have to work graveyard and be a full-time student. And at this point, I didn't know if I was going to join. But as time got closer, I decided that we were going to try and make it work. I didn't know how we were going to make it work, but it didn't hurt trying. I wanted to do this program because my kids deserve better. They deserve the world. But I needed this for myself too. I wanted to be more than just a stay-at-home mom. I wanted to be a super mom who can do it all. I didn't want to settle. I wanted more. Don't get me wrong, it was very hard, probably the hardest thing I've done. While in Europe, I had to look for daycares, which is not easy. Be a full-time student, be a mom and a wife. A normal day for me was waking up early to get myself ready, waking up the kids, getting them ready, then waking up Alan after he had just came from work maybe an hour before, and then out the door. Then dropping off the kids to daycare, because daycare, being at school till 5, rushing out to get the kids. As some of you saw, we always ran out because we had 30 minutes to get the kids. When we got home, I let Alan sleep for 2 hours. After he went to work, I would stay up sometimes until midnight to get my homework and deliverables done. When I would visit my family, I would get pushback. They always tried to discourage me and ask, how can I put myself first before the kids? That I was dumping my kids so I can go have fun. When in reality, I was doing it for them. I didn't want to kill myself every day working two shifts and never get to see my family. I don't want to be too tired to even play with my kids. That's not a life I want for me and my family. I wanted to be able to work one good stable job and still have the energy to play with my kids. I was always busy. I felt like I can never have a break. Neither did Alan. That was the other hard part of getting to Europe every day. Watching my husband sleep no more than 3 hours every day. But we all kept holding on, telling each other it's only temporary, it's only for a year. This year felt like the longest year ever. In the beginning of October, I had a miscarriage. I wasn't going to let that drag me down. I had two loving kids who needed me. So I pushed through. I went through so many lows that it was hard to see that I'm finally here. It's finally the end to this chapter. Finally, when we got our internship, things started turning around for us. My family accepted where I stand with my career and eventually got the words, "I am proud of you." We were also able to move from our studio to get to something bigger. We bought a car because our car was old and breaking down. But for the record, I love that car because it made it possible for us to get to Europe. Now comes all the thank yous. I want to thank my number one supporter, my husband. He never pushed me down. He motivated me like no one else. I also want to thank my coach, Bernadette, because she always listened and understood, as well as helped me see other perspectives. Thank you, Marshawn. He was hard, but he helped me understand the business world, which I really appreciate. Also for allowing me to bring my kids to the program on occasion when daycare wasn't an option. I also want to thank Student Services because they helped us when we were drowning. Thank you to my colleagues that always had a positive energy and made everyone feel like this was our second home and really everyone that was there for us and helped us be here. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Karina, for your powerful words. It's truly a vulnerable time for you to be able to share your story. Thank you so much for doing that with us. I'd like to pass it now to Dr. Hyman. We may have skipped over one of our graduates, and we want to definitely make sure that we honor and acknowledge every single one of our graduates. So, Dr. Hyman.
Hey, everybody. I am so sorry about that. And she's my own coachee. I want to make sure that we recognize Jesus Lazaro. He was an intern at Facebook. So we appreciate you, Jesus, and congratulations.
Hi, Europe graduates. It's Mel Bowes. I heard about your hard work over the past year and wanted to let you know how impressed I am with you. You all should be proud of yourselves for all you've done to get to graduation. You've all stuck with it for a full year, even with all that 2020 threw at you. And it was a lot. So congrats, you did it. Now you're ready for the next challenge. I know things aren't always easy, but you've got this. Stay focused on your goals, advocate for yourselves, always be open to learning something new, and you'll be ready. Sending you my very best for your future. Hi.
It's now my pleasure to introduce our alumni chair board, Lee Von T. Haywood, to administer the alumni oath to make us official. Lee is an application specialist for Vista Entertainment Studios and an alumnus of EULA Class 7. Lee, please lead us through the alumni oath.
Karina, thank you so much for that introduction. I really appreciate that. But first, before we get into the alumni oath, I would just like to say, oh my God, there are so many congratulations, right? They just don't end. And especially from me, I want to say congrats to everyone being recognized tonight. It is truly a momentous occasion. And I know all of you are eager to make this official after a very long year. And I know that you guys don't want to hear another speech, but hear me out first. I would first like to say that I am blessed and honored to deliver the alumni oath to an outstanding EULA class. And I know very well the type of fortitude and strong character it takes to complete this program. Between all of the expectations that Europe demands of you all and the lives that you still have to live outside of your learning communities, it is truly an inspiring story that each one of you will carry for the rest of your lives. I am encouraged, despite the circumstances we face in the nation today, that we can remain optimistic and continue to thrive despite the adversity. And having had the opportunity to share time with some of you, whether it be at an event or simply striking up a conversation at West LA, I know that all of you are brilliant and talented, and this is simply a foothold to propel you up your own mountain of success, because you are capable of achieving anything that you truly apply yourselves to. So don't be disheartened or lose hope over what you may hear in the 24-hour news cycle. You're joining an alumni body of bright minds, tenacious, adaptable, and compassionate individuals. And rest assured in the fact that we as alumni are all in this together. The Europe program is over for you now, but now you start the longest phase of Europe, and that is the alumni phase. And keep in mind, it is for life. And you will forever hold the distinction of Europe alumni wherever you may go. And the network that you are joining reaches from the West Coast to the East. So the family you are joining is organized, educated, and everywhere. Take the opportunities afforded to you and use them to your advantage. Europe gave you the platform to let you realize your own strengths, talents, and potential, and where you can grow to take what you've learned and apply it. And I know you will find what each of you are seeking to achieve. And now, the part I know all of you have been waiting for. If you would, please join me in reciting the alumni to officially induct you all into the alumni fam. Now, please, if you could raise your right hands for me. I pledge that as a member of the Europe National Alumni Association, I will continue to uphold and promote Europe's mission and core values. I will strive for excellence and realize my potential. I will use my time and talents to contribute to the success of Europe, its students, and its alumni. I will take action in the movement to close the opportunity divide. I take this oath freely as a promise to lift while I climb and to be a lifelong ambassador of Europe. Congratulations, Class 7. You all deserve it so much.
Thank you, Lee, and congratulations to my fellow graduates. We've come to the end of our ceremony and at the end of our Europe long journey. As many of us know, Europe Los Angeles is sunsetting in 2021. And we are the second to last class to graduate. This is not Class 7's finish line. And this is not the finish line of our Europe community in Los Angeles. Over the past years, we have engraved our community norms in our hearts, and we will continue lifting while we climb. Our challenge is to ensure the success of our colleagues and continue to lay the groundwork of Class 8 and future generations of our community. Typically in these events, we would wrap by encouraging you to make your way to the reception space next door for hors d'oeuvres and refreshments. We're all virtual. I invite you to step into your kitchen for a snack. Thank you all for attending Class 7's graduation ceremony. This achievement would not be possible without our extended year family, corporate partners, volunteers, family, staff, fellow colleagues. Thank you for being a part of this movement. Class 7, we did it.